Today we're going to use JASP to do a repeated measures design and a correlational design with paired data. We launch JASP and then we open a file that's on the computer. This file is called XXX. The data load into JASP, and we're primarily concerned with these columns, these two quiz scores that our subjects took. Now, these are in a ratio scale, and they were used to predict the final exam score. Now, we could correlate either of these particular quiz scores as predictor variables of the final. But for this example, we're not concerned with the final, per se. We're concerned with asking two questions about the first and second quiz. The first question is, did students do substantially better on one quiz compared to the other? That would be a repeated measures design. The second question is, are these two quiz scores correlated? In other words, did students who did well on the first quiz also do well on the second quiz? And did those students who do poorly on the first quiz tend to do poorly on the second quiz? Well, to answer the first question, the difference between the average score on the first quiz and the average score on the second quiz, let's go into t-tests. And it's going to be a paired samples t-test. So let's get these two variables, the first quiz and the second quiz, over here. And in addition to the t-test, let's do a non-parametric test, the Wilcoxon signed rank test. Let's also take a look at normality, mean difference, effect size, confidence intervals, and let's get the descriptives. Okay, now we're going to look over here at the p-values. Whether we used a traditional t-test for paired data or a Wilcoxon non-parametric test for the difference, we did not come close to being significant. Now, we should stick with the non-parametric measure because, as you can see, we looked at normality with a Shapiro-Wilk test, and we found that the difference between the two quizzes deviated substantially from normality. So we've answered the first question. There is not a significant difference between the first quiz and the second quiz. Now, let's answer a different question. Did the same students who scored very high on the first quiz also score high on the second? That is a question of correlation. So here, we're going to look at a correlation coefficient. I'm going to go with a Spearman since normality may be a problem here. And let's go ahead and plot the correlation matrix and the relevant statistics. And let's get these two variables, the first quiz and the second quiz. So, here is the correlation between the first two quizzes. It's very low, almost zero. And of course, it would not be statistically significant. If we try to plot it, we see that it really does not look like much in terms of a linear regression. Okay, so we have answered the second question. And the second question was, is there a correlation between these two measures? And the answer is apparently not.